Is it better to buy a car from a dealership, or should you buy a car through a private sale? That's what we're going to find out. I'm Sherry Primack, a teacher, professional car buyer, and auto expert with over a decade experience helping thousands of consumers. I've hosted car shows, been a regular on the news, and reviewed the coolest cars. But helping the car buying public is what I do best. So for any car buying advice, make sure to subscribe. Welcome to Car Help Corner, where we help you, the consumer, master the process of car buying and car ownership. Now, it's no secret that buying a car can be a pretty complicated and stressful process, and there's a lot of people that would rather just avoid the entire process of visiting a dealership and dealing with a salesperson that's going to pressure you into buying a car and sell you a bunch of extras that you really don't need. So instead, a lot of people would rather just avoid the hassle altogether and consider other options, like perhaps buying a car through a private sale. But is it really better to buy a car through a private sale? And what are the advantages and disadvantages of buying a car from a dealership versus a private sale? Well, make sure to stick around to the end of the video because that's what we're going to find out. So let's start with private sales and the advantages that it offers. One of the main advantages, of course, is the fact that you get to know the owner of the car that you're buying it from. And you get to know a little bit about that car's history, and you don't have to go through the hassle of dealing with a salesperson and all the high pressure sales tactics that come along with that. It's no secret that a lot of consumers just loathe going to a car dealership and buying a car in that way. It's one of their least favorite things to do, along with going to the dentist or doing their taxes. So buying a car through a private sale from another individual allows you to avoid that entire process altogether. Another benefit with this is that you get to know the car's former owner, and you get to know a little bit more about how the car was taken care of and maintained. When you buy a car from a dealership, the best you can really hope for is to get a history report on the car and hope that includes some information about the car's maintenance history and how well it's been serviced. When you buy a car through a private sale, however, you get the opportunity to ask for service records and get a more detailed look on how the car has been maintained, as long as the owner has kept all of that information. Dealing with the former owner means you can ask all kinds of valuable questions, like whether the car has had any serious repair work done, how often it's had oil changes and other fluid changes performed, whether it's had any kind of rust protection, or any other kind of paint protection, or anything that might interest you and make the car more valuable. These are the kinds of things that you really just can't ask at the dealership level, because the dealership ultimately doesn't know a lot about the car's history. Another great thing about a private sale is that it usually gives you more negotiating power when compared to a dealership, and it gives you an opportunity to get a much better deal and a better price. Dealerships usually have a set price and a set profit margin, so there's only so much negotiating you can really do with them. But with a private sale, that negotiating power is increased, and you have a much better chance of getting a much lower price. Ultimately, I do think private sales do make sense for certain buyers. They especially make sense for those who are looking for a super low-priced value car that you probably wouldn't find at a regular dealership. They also make sense for enthusiasts who are looking for perhaps a sports car or a collector car, where it's actually very valuable to know more about the former owner, how well they maintain the car, and have that history documentation. There are, however, a lot of things that you do need to watch out for with a private sale, and they can end up costing you a lot of money in the end if you don't do it properly. One of the biggest problems with the used car private sale market is the abundance of scams and unlicensed sellers. Unlicensed dealers, otherwise known as curbsiders, are individuals who are selling a car without a dealership license, and they're instead pretending to be individuals who are selling a car privately. Because they don't have a dealer license, they don't have to follow any of the dealership rules, and they're usually individuals who are selling cars that are nothing but junk, usually salvaged cars or rebuilt cars, or cars that have a lot of problems that are advertised for suspiciously low prices, and they're pretending to be individuals selling the car privately themselves. The private seller market is also filled with all kinds of scams, such as individuals who are advertising cars for really attractive looking prices, only later you find out that the car doesn't actually exist, and they're individuals from some faraway place who are just trying to get you to send them money. Private sales are such a buyer's beware type of situation, and there's so many potential red flags that can lead to major issues later on, which leads to my next big problem with private sales, which is the fact that you really don't have any serious form of consumer protection. When you buy a car through a private sale and you later discover some sort of major issue, like for example, you bought a car that has a serious engine problem, or you bought a car from an unlicensed dealer that has some kind of rebuilt title or salvage title, and you want to go and get your money back, you really don't have any kind of authority or government body to go to that regulates private sales. This is really one of those situations where you really need to watch what you're doing and take all the necessary precautions to protect yourself as much as possible. Now, before I share any more tips, if you're getting value out of this video, make sure to like and subscribe. I've got lots of great car buying advice information, all designed to help you with your next car purchase. Now, let's move on to car dealerships, which have their own wide range of benefits and disadvantages. Now, let's start with the first major benefit to buying a car from a dealership, where, as opposed to buying a car from a private sale where it's a total buyer beware situation, when you buy a car from a dealer, you're actually buying a car in a well-regulated environment where you have full consumer protection. Depending on where you're located, dealers do have certain rules that they need to follow, and a lot of those rules are designed to protect you as the consumer. For example, here in Ontario, dealerships are required to advertise cars with a true all-in price, and they're not allowed to charge you any additional fees or extras that are not included in the advertised price. They're also required to disclose certain information, such as whether a car has been involved in a serious accident, has a rebuilt or salvaged title, or has been used as a former taxi or rental car. There are many rules like this that a dealership is required to follow, all designed to protect you. So if you were to buy a car, you find out later that the dealership perhaps broke one of these rules, then you do have some recourse. If you buy a car only later to discover that there's a serious problem with it, you can always go back to the dealership to try and find a solution, and the dealership might be willing to cooperate with you, especially if you found out that the dealership did not disclose something that they're legally required to do so. If there's a problem, you might also be able to go to your dealership regulatory authority for wherever you're located, and they might be able to help intervene and solve the problem. On top of having better overall consumer protection and more peace of mind, you also have the opportunity to build a relationship with the dealership, which could be advantageous for you later on. You also get more options and more flexibility. If you want certain options, like say an extended warranty plan, you usually have the opportunity to buy one, and you can also finance the car through the dealership if you already don't have your own financing approved. Now, when it comes to dealer extras and financing, there's a whole new layer of homework that needs to be done there to make sure that you're getting the best deal possible and not overpaying or paying for something that you don't need. But in any case, the option is there when you buy from a dealership, and you just don't get those choices through a private sale. Now, that being said, there are a lot of issues with buying a car from a dealership that many people are aware of, and the first ultimately has to do with just the whole unpleasant atmosphere of being taken advantage of and overpaying for your car. Like I touched on earlier in the video, a lot of people are just uncomfortable with the dealership process, and they're worried that they're going to get taken advantage of by the salesperson and through the whole haggling process that can eat up a lot of time and energy and ultimately end up paying more than you should. That being said, there's a lot of things you can do to make sure that the process goes as smooth as possible and you ultimately get a good deal in the end. For one thing, do some research on the dealership you're buying from itself. See whether people had a positive or negative buying experience and see what kind of reviews they wrote about the dealer online. If you feel that you're buying from a reputable dealership and they have a car that you're interested in, then make sure that you're paying a fair price, negotiate the price as much as possible, and make sure that you're not paying any unnecessary extra fees. If you're going to be financing a used car purchase, then it's a good idea to shop around to find the best rates beforehand so that the cost of borrowing is as low as possible. Also, make sure that you're not getting sold on any unnecessary extras. If the dealership tries to sell you all kinds of additional add-ons like extended warranty plans, maintenance plans, rust protection, just say no to all of those extras until you've had a chance to do some research and decide whether you really need them or not. And finally, this step goes for both private sales and car dealerships. If you're buying a used car, make sure that you get a pre-purchase inspection done by an independent mechanic. I don't care what kind of used car you're buying, what kind of condition it is, or how good it looks. If you're buying a used car from either a dealership or a private sale, you have to get it checked out by your mechanic first to make sure that there's no hidden problems. A pre-purchase inspection is the single most important thing you can do when buying a used car because it's going to provide you with all kinds of valuable information, like whether the car has any serious problems with it, whether it's been well maintained, and whether it's had any serious accidents that you should know about. Now, having said all of that, when my clients ask me whether it's better to buy a car from a dealership or a private sale, I often tell them that the safest option is to go with the dealership. Although neither option is perfect, you do get more flexibility, more options, and more consumer protection when you buy a car from a dealership, which makes it a safer choice. Buying a car can be enough of a hassle as is, so I'd rather take some of the problematic variables out of the equation altogether, such as the buyer beware situation, the curbsiders, and the scammers. Let me know what you thought of this video, and if you have any recommendations for future car advice videos or car comparisons, just leave a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe, and if you want to check out some similar videos, you can check out these links right over here. And if you need any additional car buying advice, recommendations, or help with getting a great deal on your next new car purchase, check out carhelpcanada.com. Their team of experts would be happy to help you out. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.